Tá éirnig a dul rimirce go nuárach leis na cianta. Cruach fáilte bhúr roimh na gaeil a chnicam mar sa treiseo, I ngeall ar an meas a hil na gluinte a tháinig rompa. Sa chlár deirnach seo, builhamid le reint das na héirnig nua in nuárach, agus cíhamid an tán glas ag ceansú na cahraach. Nu áireach, caithir imircach a bhfuil níos mó éireannach agus gaeil mhericánach ínte ná an éon chaithir eile is stáit éantathe mherica. Bíon an córthe siléire ar neart agus ar chur le chéile na néirnach le fiscint an só gach ar ach ar ascu le cúig. Si paráid lá le Padraigh i gcathair nu áireach, an phráid chaithirge is mó agus is sinne ar domhan. Bhí an chéad phráid ann ar an 16 díag de bhárta, 16 seasca dó, ceire bliana díag sul ar síníag forógra na saoirse. Tá spántas creidimh, tradisiúin, cultúr agus cóchta atá sa phráid, a léiríonn éireacht ada na néirnach sa chathair seo.
Is iontach láidir í an teagmháil idir nua áireach, an chathair is tábhachtaí ar domhan agus éireann. Agus bíonn fréamhacha na teagmhála bunaithe sna glúine nár stop riamh ag obair go dtíon na dua agus eilis, agus nár stop riamh ag chothú phobal gaeilach dóibh féin anseo. Cé nach bhfuil mórán ag teacht go nuárach ó éiring níos mó, bhíonn sé fós dóchasach agus dearfach anseo, agus bhaítear fáilte mhór an gcathair díreach mar a bhuar muintir na héireann san am fadó.
It's 1931. It's the pit of the Depression in the United States. 57 stories up, and these guys look like they're sitting at a bar. And the guy who was doing this photograph, it was a publicity photograph for Rockefeller Center, and he told them, don't look at the camera. They're all talking to each other. There's one guy on the right who's looking directly at the camera. To me, it was the great Irish-American, you don't tell me what to do, you know, kiss my Irish ass, as we say in New York. Don't look at the camera. I'm not going along with this. It was that great urban Irish-American attitude that that whole photograph captured for me. These are the grandsons of rural people. They found a trade, they found an attitude, they found a home. They've defined a whole part of working class America. And we're only at this point 70 years away from the famine. They've made this leap. They're not only in the city, they're making the city, they are the city.
Be an acme ibre chéana as éiring a hógan chathir, a líon na bairne, na hárclana, agus na halí rinke, len a gud aurán, a gud scéalta, agus a gud cioil.
Generally speaking, traditional music wasn't highly valued because it was the bogman's music. And to be viewed as an art form and appreciated as an art form, that's a relatively recent development. There was a kind of new populism in the air in the 1980s in America. People were saying, you know, culture is a bit more than just going to the symphony and going to theater. This is a multicultural society with lots of great art forms. And we got swept up in that movement, and suddenly Irish music was starting to be viewed as an art form.
So I got the Clancy brothers a hashim tired how he was older. I guess we just in Shogun you a couple of strider here in Greenwich Village. There I should rather like there was the school just to us. Cúrsaí cultúra agus cúrsaí ceáil don na héiríní an éit na roise roimh sin agus a chaine le tá sé ag dul an cinn rinám.
The end of the Northern Ireland Troubles has led to a whole reassessment of what is Irish news, what is interesting to Americans. Northern Ireland was almost a standby that every few days there'd be a story about Ireland in the news. That's gone. but has been replaced in some ways by the arts and culture revolution, which is very, very positive over here.
When people think of Ireland, that's what they think of. You know, they think of the spoken word, the music. And certainly for us, as you know, being here in New York, that's what's relevant. It's, you know, the culture.
Tán Irish Art Centre lárnach a saol cultúra nuárach o 1962. Mar aithantas ar a bhfuil buinte amach aige, tá rialtas na héireann agus cathair nuárach ag cóib drú chun ionad nua ar fiú na milliúin dollar é a thógant ar thiamh in aice leis an ionad de tán fé láthair.
The new centre, we really want to just look at, you know, a dynamic image of Irish America for the 21st century. You know, to really be it across all disciplines, theatre, live music, film, dance, particularly with the exhibition programme as well. You know, so it's paying homage to history and recognising the great history that we have, but also looking forward.
Be it Kieran O'Reilly agus Charlotte Moore a bhunaig an Irish repertory theatre, agus os glíoch na dórse den Gaeadúrán, Mí Bhean Óir, 1988. Sin tain champántas drámaíochta a bhí ag obair ó hús deireadh gach bliana ar drámaí éirnacha agus drámaí Gaeil Mheiriceánacha. Tagann níos mó na 3,000 duine go dtí an Auckland gach blian.
I think Kieran and I came in at just the right moment and took advantage of an Irish movement that was happening. Frank McCourt wrote Angela's Ashes. River Dance happened at about the same time. And all at once, we were extremely sought after, extremely popular. And if you did good work, you were noticed and applauded, and we were.
I'd like to find out who it is.
I am the man, Mr. Kitchener.
Father Dolan.
I wasn't really that aware of my Irish background before we started this theater. I knew I was Irish, of course, but I took advantage of that rich heritage which was in me. That heritage and that use of language and that feeling of Irishness has just been terrific for me in all my work since we began.
This is all mighty fine. Go on. I wish I'd a witness if I'd make you pay for this.
An Irish repertory theatre in Chin, our Clamorla Rai, Agus Lerinche Drami, Erena, Special Tinchin, no Drami, Achum Ereni, Maracanach, Marcus Owl, Eugene O'Neill. Estoyer Goal, Ergoy Goal, Sinny Small and Shohanishna, Martha Maraclea.
Is the von a limnie, George Heslin, came the chid honored Samuel Beckett, a glashtin a trinoide. Hanishag on the warlock, civilian gavile, condolish and ashtoirucht, marli vaha.
Hello. Hey Aidan, how are you? Listen, just want to confirm. So tonight, we definitely have seats. We have the Northern Ireland Bureau coming. The Consulate General is coming, Nota Kenny's wife, Honora.
There's a great quote that I saw on a piece of sculpture on the Lower East Side of Manhattan. It said, there's three things I learned when I came to America. First of all, the streets weren't paved with gold. Secondly, they weren't paved at all. And thirdly, I was expected to pave them. So for me, that's very, very true. You know, you have got to make your own journey here. It took me 7 years to get to like this town. There were many nights of questioning, why am I here? 2002, I had a few months of unemployment as an actor. I produced a one-man show by Enda Walsh called Mr. Man. Enda Walsh was quite a big name in Ireland at the time, and he hadn't been heard of in the US. And that was kind of my first journey in taking a risk as a producer here in New York.
Tresh Gareirig Cho Mashin Le Mr. Man, Hur George Spesh Selera Hoirucht, Agus Vonnega Champantus Dramiach de Fein, Origin, Ira Vilagus Ado. Cho Malishin, Bunnig George an chéad éile drámaíochta éirinach. Seo an ceathrú bliana ag an bhéile, agus tá haid féin in isice ar éile a drámaíochta nuárach.
Bhain you spúfa.
Maybe a bit older.
A lot older. Bleeding ancient looking I am. That's what the smack does to you.
Oh, not ancient looking, Natalie. Oh, very, very good looking you are.
Thank you.
In 3 years, we've presented work by 48 Irish playwrights. 11 of those have been new plays. Most of them have been American premieres, and in some cases, world premieres.
What'd you do if I kissed you? Would you scream?
I won't scream, no.
What's beginning to happen now is the work that's been presented here in America has now been taken back to Dublin, which is kind of the cross-pollination that we wanted to see happen. I would say the first Irish Theatre Festival, most of our audience are not Irish people. Certainly most of my friends didn't come to this country to explore their Irish culture. They didn't come to this country to explore Irish theatre. And I think when you get here, for the first 7 years of your journey here, you're probably running away from your Irishness. You feel the energy of the city is very real. And certainly in all my time living here, that never leaves you. It all happens here. This is the crossroads of the world in terms of artists coming through. I mean, on any given week, I would definitely meet two or three actors, directors, playwrights from Ireland, all passing through New York. So I don't feel very far away from Ireland, even now. You know, I often say that when you're in Ireland, you feel New York is a million miles away. When you're in New York, you feel Dublin is a mile away. It feels very close.
Tas Ross Cré e Gunda Hebradorn de Fiona Walsh, Ashtor, Firshore, agus DJ, a hannig an uarach in laidiag nocha cuig.
Bhí mé Geary thús a chur le heistoracht. Sála fuair mé an equity card, glach mé amateur drama parts off Broadway. Ba é an Irish Repertory Theatre an cé díine a thug post mar eistoir profisiúnta dom in drámaí d'ar teidl de Seachrán. Le Dian Busico. Bhí dul mór agam sa dausa ó bhí mé mar lena bhóg. Cath mé blianta ag gabháil don rinca géalach, don valé agus don snag ceol, agus mé am a dhéagóir bhí dul ola mór agam sa ceol disco. Bhain mé ar tanamh as na clubanna an seo nuair a thosaigh mé ag freistáil orthu ar dús. Is all she an deirdh Lena Lloyder, Hilary 15 million vata agus ceol ard le cloisteáil uathu. Sin é a bhí uaim, sin a bhí uaim go Géir agus bhain mé an tanamh as. Bhí sé an adúirthe dom a bheith am a DJ agus a bheith ag gabháil don ceol. Is fun sé bhór íomhnas dom é im a héal. Well, is a gomis mise an taon ban éireann a chatá an a DJ technicol in nua áirc. Dan níor falom cuig bliana o hin gomín buintach leis an saol technicol in nua áirc ní creidinn é. Tá sé an a dúrtha dúin mar éireann ach bheith dréach dúil agus mid caint le díne. Winning she shin or fad lish and dreep the togwin. Say on me and McConta togwin lefirna. Me has the in a win germ of the yen of our shin a reeve. Toshe tovok the gay shin of egg or cool or nanya egoni. Is quid for DNA capon.
On a shaskadi than Gierce Kateraig, the an East Village, Tree of Lahir and Richol Tuir in the Wauruk. Him ask na Virginov of Via Titimas Hele, Agus na Nina Gandidan, Vlahig, Pobl Eagsuil Aliantori. For Yeran the Nochtodi than Gierce Kate, the Reintva Ernach in a mass.
There was a lot of people, Irish folks, knocking around East Village. Who are all doing some really extraordinary things, you know, artists and poets and writers and people like that who wouldn't have been as comfortable in the Bronx or Sunnyside. They weren't looking to recreate some kind of Irishness abroad. They were looking to kind of further their own artistic pursuit, if it were.
A Kiat Fihedo, St. Mark's Place, a Grilor in East Village, Dusquil Cafe Bug in Nadia Cochto Nae. Agus níor a bhada gur áid fé leith a bhí ann do bhaointear na héireann sa chathair.
Sinéad was remarkable. because it shouldn't have happened. Do you know, it was a storefront in St. Mark's Place, just right off the park. It was a hole-in-the-wall place.
When Sinead opened, it seemed like something very, very positive had happened. And it wasn't the shillelagh paddy whackery of the Midtown kind of bars, you know? It was just the natural kind of thing for me to kind of go there, and that became my kind of unofficial Irish embassy. Everything I needed to figure out, someone was sitting in a little table beside me, and they were so welcoming.
Jan Mark Geary, hic ir hair óg Karl go dian East Village in Laidig Nocha Dó, agus é a suil le shlí vaha vintamach mar chumadóir áurán.
And I played every single night and just would bartend and work in the cafe and just squawk that I had a gig. And everyone did that, you know, because the challenge was, like, the best of the best are here. So you get up and your arse is hanging out and it just doesn't cut it. And you go off and you go, okay, I'll be better. I'll be better tomorrow, you know. I remember writing songs and being able to perform them the night after. That's how many gigs you could do here. You still can, you know. You kind of own up to what it is you want and desire. And New York teaches you how to ask for it, as opposed to, I'm grand, I'm fine, everything's grand, sure, we're all grand here in the dark, don't worry about us stuff, you know? Which is absolutely what we come from, you know? There's no one turning around to you and going, you're kind of a braggart. Something really odd about having confidence. Confidence is almost a liability in Ireland.
Fiona McGillicuddy a mask na sluite a dog eras na hochtodi den geard se kaite. Treshti triel a wint as postane ag sula, hokrik si dolishtach sa start her a vish. Ha si muin an ish e goras na skailin a pebli.
Vi se an difruler fa the scrivenlam an caid la vi me mar onadi e skull pebli hus an sa. Agus hannig me a walio an skull agus thuris le maricale. You know, if I was to be knocked down in the hallway, they wouldn't stop to pick you up. I was just near cred me, co dacrog. The vi she dumse mar vi, you know, the hay fast dacks wrong. I was the hiasak dini suus. I was hail Mary near a hag dus jack. I was vi anakid, you know, mass. I suppose there clear one. I was agla, riven moon tour. You know, near rev queen than rod she now. Was hain tha. Perception on Massim Gwil nis mo smakdeg muntori le aile hairacht airnach namar ta bejerig diniele ta kind of collaring mar, you know, strict teachers. Ta rud on ni like no not taking any messing, you know, just a ta ounce of character. The character na gwaile is not will she concur suus le shanamarka. Tawakta gan narodi maha kalund. Mard vi kaidan ord eg agusta kaidan fosagum braham. Mard bejer gurgail me ta kaidan idachishigum agus kaidan agum leshna parsti. Bejer nak willig eg, you know, diniela gan an rud shin sakulra.
Via con stat shervish igoni tawachtak agus tarangtak mart livaha dona herinig. Nihawan obarode gorefshe rezun tabuan agus slan, ak komalashin dairik gamala iva na herinig margoine fiuntaka agus moninacha agus iedig play leshan stat shervish.
I think, you know, the Irish go back to day one with the NYPD. I have met American people that were so accustomed to meeting Irish police officers and their stuff, they thought that, I guess, that they imported us from Ireland just to become cops. Yeah, so. I always say my parents gave me wings and roots. Roots that you never forget where you came from, and wings that brought me to the greatest city in the world.
Dog Denis Mulcahy, Shepale na Carriga, Stride Valley Bug, Dushkurt Korkui, Agashani Gunu Auruk, Enediog Shaska Shacht, Ravli and Nyishan, Husheshdachs and NYPD. Dan Denis, Erfat Trucha Blian, Susquad Buoma.
Having an Irish brogue or accent or whatever you want to call it, it definitely helped you because, you know, a lot of the big chiefs, bosses in the police department would have that Irish heritage, you know, would their parents or grandparents would have come from Ireland or whatever, and we got breaks that maybe I wouldn't have got if it wasn't for the fact that I was from Ireland. It had security. If you were going to raise a family or whatever, it really was the place to be. And you had a retirement that when you did your time, you got your pension, whether it rained or shined. So, you know, you weren't going to become a millionaire, but you were able to raise a family and make a living.
Nurukhuig Mac Dennis, Sean, Ishtachs and NYPD. Yinshe Marina Aher River, Agase Shul, Friden and Akarach. Rauniaga. Don Aonad Sheravishi Egandala, Marwil Sko na Boilini Egobir.
When I got into the emergency service unit, it was actually his last year. I was fortunate to actually go to a job where I had to call my father to the scene. Sure enough, he shows up. And after breaking my chops or why I'm calling him, you know, he went over and he took care of the package. And that was actually another proud moment where I got to see him in person do his job. So. After that, he retired, and about a year and a half, maybe 2 years after that, then, when I became detective, I got his shield. Although they still break my chops about it being dirty and old.
Was it just that first year?
Yeah.
That
yeah.
Mm-hmm. And a bunch of friends from here came, traveled with us to Ireland, and we had some great parties in that house. Unfortunately, that house is empty today. They went to Ireland at a very young age, you know, and visited the grandparents. You know, and I think that's important. You know, it's sad in a way, of, regardless of any nationality that you are, is we know talk to somebody and they don't know where their father and mother were born or where they grew up. Like you're losing something. To me, your heritage is important, very important.
The fire department and police department in New York City, it's always been a very familial job. Decades, even 100 years ago, both particular occupations were kind of looked down upon. And the Irish as a group were looked down upon for a long time. So those professions were consequently given to the Irish. Oh, we'll let the Irish do it because nobody else wants to. The Irish being what they are, they made those jobs into respected occupations.
Dos Jim McCaffrey in Ys in gná hailach Gaeil Vericánach. Fi tref si fada categ a winter river I Sheravís an phobil. San NYPD, san Arum, agus a Teravís doitán.
And 82 goes, first two, 31 goes, first two, phone alarm for a fire, structural fire. 82, 31 go, first two, structural.
Being a few generations removed, I would certainly say I'm proud to be an American. But I'm also proud to be an American of Irish descent. I guess we were somewhat Americanized being born here, but there was always reminders and just everyday instances of that Irish influence. On that particular day, I was home, but I found out, you know, shortly after the attacks began, that my brother-in-law, my wife's brother, Oriel Palmer, who was a battalion chief on the FDNY, was working that day. He was like another brother to me, even though it was my brother-in-law officially, but we were very close. We'd known each other for years before we were firemen, and he's one of the influences on me to become a fireman because he was a couple of years ahead of me.
This is Jim's uniform that he wears to the parade every year. And the one year after 9/11, Jim wasn't going to march because he just didn't have the heart to go and march in the parade again. And I said, you marched every year in that parade with Oreo. Why don't you go? And he said, I'm not going to go. So I went and had this pin made up of Oreo's picture. And the next morning when Jim got up, the day of the St. Patrick's Day parade, he took the coat out of the closet and he saw it, and I said, he's with you at the parade, he's going with you today.
Is priavifigach doitane Oreo Palmer, agus rishe gudian trucha triu ur lar sa tour has la an air. Bien hia dinne a frish laher na tubishta ar an shachto hochtu ur lar.
We got tanks, isolated pockets of fire. We should be able to knock it down with two lines. Where go that? 78th floor, number 1045, call Hans.
What day are you in, Oreo?
South Tower, Adam. South Tower.
478?
South Tower, we got numerous civilians. We're going to get two engines up here. Tiger 7-1-5.
Being a familial job, a lot of firefighters and first responders lost fathers, brothers, sons. If I just think of all the names I know of guys I know personally and just names that you would rattle off from the list of the 343, there's an awful lot of Irish and Irish-American names on there.
Bog Joe Woolhead of La Clea Gnu Aurach, Eg Tus na Nochadi. Dibrishe Satunskul Togala, Achba Yakarer na Billy a Yeel.
For my space of Green Graph Adorach, Nurvi made Demly in a Dish, Dosche in a fashion, Vetara, September 11, Havilis the Hain. Nurkulmerin Radio, Gervul Etalon and World Trade Center, Rugmig Rhymer a camera, Nirvagumach, dead dollar. Vima Mahoney a meds at Jackson Heights, Queens. Ishdachlom a shop of 99 cent, can I made their roll of film than camera, lame air train, Hustle made Togal Greengraph, Mach Tweedon in Og. August and train a Dulladro Manhattan, Hunnick made a Twin Towers, three Hinne, Machwem, Hooling Mare Broadway, Vina Meeted in the Gwal Harem, August a Dullar Monotro. Hustle made Rishi's Lauren Asroyd, Rishmay Chamber Street or West Broadway, Harta Cairn and Quig Block on the Towers. Dech my Sousa, because being Tower of Titum. Chula wow moor on Slua. We got in a trace in Ryarkshaw Echo, like an arm gain, a Gavimidanon, a figure, the firefighters, a gear of those stocks at Tower, Rinamiduntas, that Grogot, Visha Dochrete. Who made the photo agency in Lashin, September 11th? I was glad she'd Green Graph. I was sure she'd got out. We should glow a nooch down. I was irish here, foot and down. In the Yixin, we made first to on Green Graph of Lockett and at Hogal. I was quick got rid of Yaus at Shinamach. To my play like Green Graph of Doroth and Ishle, shame Lena. Caig will raw villu in Green Graph Blackagum than Atogal and Trade Centre. It's unorg as privileged to me. Hasig when we were gubber photojournalist Magoni, you ain't tour him again, good door look to show him a hail. Ach Sean New Auruk. I guess she didn't say it's rud a date of Titum and Mach, so Kahar show.
The vona valian skelli gegunte hirie donal o suilevain, a chuiger imerke gan uorok in naediuk hochto caher, a lorog ebre san arnail togala. Len ich reharache agus ich refuur vonig se navelas, a tainish se mask na gunrohori furgeniachte is mo in uorok.
But in perspective, it's probably the most important job that we have ever done and might be the most important job we will ever do. Just because of the historical event that surrounds that place. So when that job came out, it was a big job. It was 80 million or 100 million. It was a big job. And it was kind of out of our league. And I remember telling Peter, who was our chief estimator, Peter's been with us for nearly 20 years. He says, you know, Don, he says, why are we bidding this job? We won't be able to do this job. I said, fair enough, we'll bid it, let's see. He says, well, we won't be able to do it and we won't get it. I says, come on, we'll give it a shot anyway. We gave it a shot, and he got his head around. It was a very complicated job, and we won the bid. You know, and we started down there 2.5 years ago, and everything worked out extremely well for us.
This is the museum for 9/11.
You're standing on the original foundation of Tower 1. Those columns that are cut there are the original columns that went up 1,300 feet. All this is going to be preserved, covered in glass, cleaned. When the memorial opens.
When we came in here, this was just a hole, just one big hole. We created the structure. The whole plaza we pretty much done as well, like set the grades, the soil, the trees, everything like that. That would be our work.
That's a place that, you know, a billion people will walk through that place in time, you know, and they're walking an hour work that we've done there. And for anybody to go down there, especially Irish people that lost loved ones there, to be able to say, you know, something, this was built by a lot of the Irish.
Nor hannig Donal gan uorach mar chuid de lua aulvúr imercachs na hochtodí, fi sear nos morán da chó leacahe, fi seán gan neag leachach. Master Gulos kyun trocha mila ernach gan kapeshi imerke lonahe in uorak. Agus is in olkus ata kursi dolta le demlian anuas.
You know, the immigration question has become tied up with terrorism. The truth is the terrorists who did these attacks were able to camouflage themselves in this tide of immigrants who are coming into the country every day. And so we are now trying to stop that tide, and it has very profound effects all the way back through society.
Vuil ahar agus maher faki le chéile an uaurach in naedig fiha cuig, ach díla dar ar éiring chan a glaun a hógant. Ta paki ar skor an ish, agus tugan sé cuart ar an uaurach chom minic agus is féidir leis. Sé an tain slí a taige chan a vac agus clown a vic eiscint.
It's more three in that now which you'd feel cad a brun shogat leha. That you'd say to get kind of a yuk a brun shod crue agus moravish the goni nincho skai yobui eti bi a walshit nier chid falsa. A shilim kai heart on the herni cad vacu oburin cho mor nur bi an chaisha hogalt ans de tuse heid by the herni ar an nobur ruelig agus tis tad mar ik yerde gefol don drohu ei niel kitrin no di abuter pelion wale mar me hench no wale ni wish de shaharist agus es mor tru ye shin mar tad tis de gobern sha ta mac na te hagan. A sinna síl caiad do lácu leis. Hig leis tarlú go duine gan na buas a nahirart. Ní bheith Adrian abhalt ar gáil non. Mar bhí wainear hat an longa héirin ní bhuiis siad ar áist. A tuigim na duine go sinna síl a fach siad sin. Agus tá mine sésta lácu leis sin. Bé mé dealta ar Niall couple of years in the end, you can't do it. But we went in the crowd with Swiss and we were able to attach them.
People have been living here over 20 years undocumented. But the fact that you can't, you know, take your children home to meet their grandparents, I certainly think that that's a far bigger punishment than, you know, the crime of having overstayed their visa waiver. I think when you're in your early 20s, it's very hard to see that far down the road, you know, that you could find yourself here with a, you know, a spouse and children and a lot of responsibility. It's just impossible to, you know, transfer the gravity of that to young people.
The fact is that since the time of the famine, there's always been Irish coming to America. That won't change, that won't stop. There will be Irish here, there will be undocumented. And I consider it a duty to try and help them become legal and to change the immigration laws, which I think are basically fundamentally flawed. I know what they gave to this country. I know what they have contributed, and I feel very strongly that the next generation or the generation after that should have some access to America.
Tochter le a bintlish a bride im liana, agus gachiad caig a blian den starshin a chelura. Shulig na sluita suas an kuigu askul, is beg an chahir in a stad. O caider le is a pride nuorok, is nila le head in ain aitela. In Malta agus a gahracha harter nuorok, bein pridey aitula ag dina rivla le Padraigh. Onas gur féidir leo freastal ar foráid mhór ascuil a cúig. Ráníodh an bleag clíoch a tracta Lyndon mar fríomh mhair ar an bráid aitúil in Meargan County.
Nuair a bhíonn tú thar leir ceapan go dtugann tú faoi deara céard is brí le Heritage. Tá níos mó meas agat air agus déanann muid rud mór is lá le fóric. Ní dóilim go dtuigh an daoine sa bhaile cé chomh mór is atá sé dúine. Mar bhfuil taithí ad bhéir thar sáile chun is bheitchas ad. Taobh amuid an paráid mór i Caffrey, New York, bí na mílte paráide beag ar siúlaí nach chórsanach agus baile timpeall ar New York, roimh an seachtú lá déag do márta. Tá siad sin níos cosúil le na paráide sa bhaile, tá na deasanta bhaine le paráid New York éagsúil i ngeall ar stair na carta sin. Níor uair an bheith a Grand Marshal ar an bhráid seo, agus ní féidir le a bhíonn conas mar a bhuaithí mé. Tá sé cosúil leis saor sin na carach a bheith brontáirt in éireann. Ní léon rud cosúil leis an áíre. Is mór an honor é. Buíoch fint am a bheith ar lam, agus níl rud ar bin níos fearr measc na hÉireann an seo.
ní tre himpiste gul cumach o heag suil ar fraid nuorach, seachas éanáid eile ar daun.
The great harp drips with rain, but it takes more than water to dampen the Irish come St. Patrick's Day in the morning. 48,000 faithful strut up New York's Fifth Avenue.
The parade committee in New York decided to enforce a dress code so that you couldn't be lampooned as, you know, being just some ragged, ignorant person right off the boat. They're a leveler. You don't know what that person does for a living. They could be your doorman, they could be a steel worker, a bricklayer, but in a morning suit and a top hat marching up Fifth Avenue, it's about image, it's about projecting a need for respect. Which was very important, given all that was around in American popular culture about the Irish. There's no Mardi Gras element in that parade for that reason.
There may be water in those boots, but watch that strut.
You know, my mother, God bless her, used to drive her crazy to hear March 17th referred to as Paddy's Day. She thought that that was just disrespectful. He's a saint. That's disrespectful. I mean, apparently, what went on March 17th, getting drunk and getting arrested and getting into a fight, she had no problem with that. I've celebrated the St. Patrick's Day Parade in New York City in just about every way, shape, and form that is humanly possible over the course of my lifetime. I mean, I marched in it with my father as a child. Then when I got on the sanitation department, I would carry the banner, the Emerald Society banner of Fifth Avenue. And then we have a pipe and drum band, and I joined the band as a drummer.
All right, guys, listen, carry on. You're doing a good job here, right?
Okay.
Thank you, Chief. Very proud of you. And I'm particularly proud of you.
We actually march in 7 St. Patrick's Day parades during the month of March. You know, of course, Fifth Avenue being the mother of them all.
In 2002, agus I fisrach a Dave Hyrach the agus a ghuachas agóni. Hug me lom chig parádi, nor na grevshi ag trí blín a dís. Bishin an céadór dum sa frastal air farad, agus bíntach an show a cur air siúl. Vrahas I vádó nua aurachán, áfach I an gahara chig me féin. Chonica maré, agus fi lá brad jasagun, ach níor thug mé leo maríisi, is féidir dúchas na hÉireanna isrú ar bhór an slite eile.
But the second half, the score is 0-0. We're going to win the second half. We win the first half, we win the second half, all right? I don't want to see a clean shot coming back here. I want to see everyone dirty, 110% with Shannon Gales, right?
Tá tennis a buint le féinúlach na Gaeil in Eabhrac, agus iad a Geary New Yorkers a dhéanamh dóibh féin, gan an núchas agus an nairacht a chailúint. Ar live a bhain, tá na himircigh seo ar an níhil a Geary socrú síos agus iad féin an neadú i measc phobal nó Eabhrac. Ar a live eile, tá gréim an irmhaite acu ar an méadán núchas a chaithead ar agant ina níag a nóing a dola.
Go on, Danny! That is your ball, Danny! That's it, Danny! Ah, no repay, Danny!
When I came here first, I walked down Fifth Avenue. I felt I had reached home in some respects, you know?
That's it, Kevin!
So it makes you feel like you're in the right place, you know? You're not a stranger. So it feels like you're following the footsteps of some great people, you know? I mean, there's something about the Irish in New York, it's just unreal, like, you know? It's a perfect match. And a lot of my friends felt the same way. They're here like 30 years, you know? It's like you're in a different country, you're in America, but yet you're seem to be in an Irish town in New York.
Rugach Diarmid Hogan im La Clia, ach ta forvor a hail mar ghinne fasta catige in the Warwick.
The St. Patrick's Day Parade in New York is one of the oldest institutions in America. As I said, the parade itself is older than the country. And it is a spectacular setting coming up Fifth Avenue. And there are at least 200,000 participants in the parade. Everybody wants to see it, but sometimes it's hard to see it from the ground. So I said, this is perfect. So every year I'm going to have a party.
Hey, Tommy boy! Hey, how are you, Jeez? Happy St. Patrick's Day! Happy St. Patrick's Day!
It's the ultimate celebration of what Irish people have been able to do in this country over the last 250 years.
Thank you so much!
Thank you so
I had a
much.
Mom!
That's great!
I hope
you'll
I'm
come again.
This year. Yeah.
Of course you are!
The parade means a lot to me because it's... I feel like it's my day, my absolute day. I just love that day, and I want everybody to celebrate it with me as much as they can. People would come here for the weekend or whatever, for the St. Patrick's Day Parade, and would be sort of a little astonished at the kiss me, I'm Irish, the green beer, all of these things that they themselves were not used to in Ireland. And of course they misunderstand what the parade is all about. The parade is not celebrating Ireland in itself. It is celebrating the Irish community that came to America, made its roots here, grew up and maintained its heritage and culture in the Irish American community.
Irish probably don't have the same presence in the city of New York as they've had, but for that one day, we show more power than anybody and more pride. And you know what the best part about the St. Patrick's Day Parade is? Out of all the parades that go up Fifth Avenue, we display with equal prominence the tricolor flag of Ireland and the Stars and Stripes of the United States. Because the Irish are as proud of either as they are of the other. The parade is just out of control. It's enormous. It goes on for hours and hours and hours.
It was kind of like we're here to stay, and we're as good as anybody, and we're going to march through the streets, and it's the sign of assertion of self. I don't find that so much anymore, you know, because Irish have arrived. They don't have to assert themselves. I like to think of it as a celebration of the immigrant experience, that, you know, the city really gave so much to the Irish, and the Irish gave so much to the city, and they created a place where these other groups have come into, and it's a celebration of that as much as it is of Irishness. That the Irish-American experience formed a door for other people to come through, and that the important thing is to keep that door open. And we were foreigners once and we're not now. What New York is a creation of different forces, and one of those really formative influences are those Irish people who came off those boats from the rural experience, and they created a different kind of city. They created attitudes and institutions that survive to this day. And what we think of as the city welcoming immigrants, didn't welcome the Irish, did the opposite. But they were able to force their way in, and in that process of forcing their way in on their own terms, they created really what is New York.
Ta dúlain nua ón de Gaeil Verica, ta níos lú imirceacha techt na mar a bhí, is ta éire áhrathe ó bhán. Ach ta il omad dúlain sárathe hana ag Gaeil nuárach. Agus na slúite éirnach agus Gaeil Vericánach ar ascal a cúig, ag ceilúra ghaachiad blian den mhúrthiúl, Caffer machnav an omatá roing. Ní bheidh deire le nuárach na Gaeil, mar ní licasíod dó imeacht.